Hi, I'm Kelly Straka, wildlife veterinarian with the Michigan Department of Natural Resources. We have put together the following video for those hunters who would like to collect lymph node samples from their harvested deer for chronic wasting disease testing through a diagnostic laboratory. To find out more about laboratories that offer CWD testing, please click the link below to be directed to our website. Tom Cooley, DNR wildlife pathologist, will now walk you through removing the medial retropharyngeal lymph nodes from your harvested deer for CWD testing. You will need a pair of disposable gloves, a knife, something to grip the nodes with, like a pair of forceps or pliers, a Ziploc bag, water, paper towels, and a 50-50 mixture of water and bleach for disinfecting. With your deer positioned on its back, feel along the throat for the Adam's apple or larynx. Once you have noticed this, use your knife to make a semicircle cut in front of the larynx and extending along the back of the jawbones. This cut will need to go deep through the tissue and muscle down to the spine. You may need to push the head down and pull the larynx towards the body to help open this area up. Once you make the cut, you will see two oblong-shaped pieces of tissue on each side of the esophagus. Lymph nodes can vary greatly in color and size. Salivary tissue is located close to the lymph nodes and is sometimes accidentally pulled and submitted as lymph node tissue. This will not work for diagnostic testing. Lymph nodes are bean-shaped and look like oysters, and the tissue is firm and retains its shape. While grasping a node with a pair of pliers or forceps, gently cut it from the remaining tissue to remove it from the head. Repeat this process on the other node. If you cut into or through the lymph nodes when removing them, it will not interfere with diagnostic testing. While removing the lymph node, if you cut into the node or other tissue that is filled with pus, please stop cutting and double bag the entire head. This deer could be a TB suspect. Contact the Wildlife Disease Lab at 517-336-5030 for further instruction. Once you remove the lymph nodes, place them in a sealed Ziploc bag, keep them cool, and contact the diagnostic lab you wish to use for further handling instructions. If you will need to store them for several days, you may freeze them. More information on these labs and their contact information can be found on our website, michigan.gov/CWD. If you are collecting samples from more than one deer, we recommend changing gloves and disinfecting tools between deer. Remove any blood, tissue, or hair from your tools and any surface that needs to be disinfected by wiping them off with a paper towel and rinsing with water. A mild detergent like dish soap can help remove dried blood or tissue, but will not properly disinfect your tools. In 2019, researchers with the National Institutes of Health confirmed that bleach can be an effective disinfectant for CWD prions on stainless steel surfaces. However, bleach may be ineffective if blood or tissue is present, so tools need to be rinsed to remove any organic material before soaking them. Once you clean off the tools, let them soak for 10 minutes in a 50-50 household bleach solution. To mix this solution, mix equal parts of bleach and water in a container. This is a caustic and concentrated mixture, so please be sure to work in a well-ventilated area and wear protective clothing and eyewear to minimize any contact with the solution. You should make a fresh bleach solution daily, and you should avoid soaking tools much longer than the recommended time. Once you remove the tools from the bleach, rinse them thoroughly and allow them to air dry in the sun if possible. Items that cannot be submersed should be cleaned, sprayed with a 50-50 bleach solution, and allowed to dry in the sun. Be safe, and as always, happy hunting.